We want to simplify the given trig expressions, which normally means we want to write the expression in terms of a single trig function. To do this, we'll be using the identities given here below in red. Since none of the terms are squared, there's no obvious substitution using the Pythagorean identities given here. So what we'll do is convert everything to sines and cosines, and then see what we can do with that. So cosecant theta is equal to 1 divided by sine theta. And then for sine theta, because this is a fraction, we're going to write sine theta over 1. And then we can write cotangent theta as cosine theta divided by sine theta. And this actually looks worse than the original expression, but notice how now, if we needed to, we could subtract these two fractions, which will be our next step. Well, to subtract these fractions, we do have to have a common denominator, which would be sine theta. So we have to multiply this fraction here by sine theta over sine theta. Now that we have a common denominator, we can subtract these two fractions. So the denominator is going to stay the same for right now. And now notice we have a common denominator of sine theta. And the numerator would be 1 minus sine squared theta. Again, it doesn't look much better, but now that we have sine squared theta, we should see if we can perform a substitution using the Pythagorean identities given here below. And often this substitution doesn't fit the form exactly as given. Notice here we have 1 minus sine squared theta. We're looking at this first equation here. If we subtracted sine squared theta on both sides, we would have cosine squared theta equals 1 minus sine squared theta. So we can substitute cosine squared theta for 1 minus sine squared theta. So this would give us cosine squared theta all over sine theta. And then we still have cosine theta over sine theta in the denominator. Now remember, a fraction bar means division. So let's go ahead and write this as a division problem. We would have cosine squared theta over sine theta divided by cosine theta over sine theta. But every division problem can be written as a multiplication problem if instead of dividing by this fraction here, we multiply by the reciprocal, or in this case, multiply by sine theta over cosine theta. So this would give us cosine squared theta over sine theta. Notice how the first fraction stays the same, times the reciprocal of the second fraction. So it's sine theta over cosine theta. And finally, we can start to see some factors that will simplify. Here we have sine theta over sine theta. And notice that here we have two factors of cosine theta. Here we have one factor of cosine theta. So one factor of cosine theta simplifies out, leaving us with one factor of cosine theta. So the given expression simplifies to cosine theta. Let's take a look at the second expression on the next slide. So again, now we're going to simplify this expression. Notice none of the trig functions are squared, so we'll go ahead and convert everything to sine and cosine again and see where that leads us. Well, tangent theta is equal to sine theta divided by cosine theta. And then for the denominator, secant theta is equal to 1 over cosine theta. And then for cosine theta, because this is in fraction form, we'll write this as cosine theta over 1. So just like in the previous example, the only thing we can possibly do is subtract these fractions here by obtaining a common denominator, which now would be cosine theta. So now we're going to multiply this by cosine theta over cosine theta. So for the moment, the numerator is going to stay the same. And then on the bottom, notice how the common denominator is now cosine theta. And the numerator would now be 1 minus cosine squared theta. Now notice we have a trig function squared, or in this case, 1 minus cosine squared theta, which should lead us to this identity here. Notice this time, if we subtract cosine squared on both sides, we would have sine squared theta equals 1 minus cosine squared theta. So we can substitute sine squared theta for 1 minus cosine squared theta. So our denominator is now sine squared theta over cosine theta. Now let's see if we can skip the division problem and write this as a multiplication problem. Right now, this is sine theta over cosine theta divided by sine squared theta over cosine theta, which means as a multiplication problem, the first fraction stays the same. And then instead of dividing by this fraction here, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal. So it's going to be times cosine theta over sine squared theta. And now we can see this is going to simplify nicely. Cosine theta over cosine theta simplifies to 1. And here we have two factors of sine theta. And here we have one factor of sine theta. So one factor will simplify to 1. This will simplify to 1. This will simplify to one factor of sine theta. So we have 1 over sine theta. So we do have it in terms of one trig function, but it's still in fraction form. And since 1 divided by sine theta is equal to cosecant theta, we'll go ahead and write this as cosecant theta. So the given expression simplifies to cosecant theta. I hope you found this helpful. We'll look at some more examples in the next few videos.